Hi, I'm Raphael, and thanks for watching. Someone you might ask, why doesn't he do more Mandela Effect videos? Well, first of all, the world is more than the Mandela Effect alone, and there are others a lot better in pointing out Emmys than I am. Moneybags 73 and Hidden Knowledge come to mind. I was more of a theories guy, and I feel I might have covered the most important ones. But by all means, please, tell me if I'm wrong. So I got thinking, and there are some personal stories that I could slip in between the lines. One of them, if true, could be more proof for my theory that the Mandela Effect is a natural phenomena that has been with us since the beginning of time itself. Not that it is that far into the past, but it will at least show ME was already a thing last century. It has all to do with what my late mother told me, and from the beginning I am going to say that my memory on this is crystal clear. My mother's name was Clementine, and she was a very religious woman, going to Catholic church almost every week. She was 39 years of age when I came along, and I had only one sibling who was 3 months shy of 17 years older than me. My mother always told me she wanted 4 children and named them after the 4 archangels, Raphael, Michael, Gabriel, and Daniel. She also said, in reference to my namesake Raphael, that he was the one that defended the gates of the Garden of Eden with a flaming sword. First of all, through my research, I found out that in Christianity, angels are only referred to as archangels twice. Roman Catholicism only named 3 angels by name, Michael, Raphael, and Gabriel, and the same beliefs exist in Islam. Then Orthodox traditions mentions thousands of archangels, but only 7 are actually named. It's only in occult, Kabbalistic, ceremonial magic that 4 archangels are invoked as guardians of the 4 quarters or directions. However, the 4th is called Uriel. Nowhere the name Daniel is mentioned as an archangel. The only link between the name Daniel and archangels is in the Book of Daniel, where the biblical figure is the first to refer to individual angels by name. As for Raphael's function, he is a YouTuber with little success. Oh no, that's me. The archangel Raphael is apparently a healer, as Raphael means it is God who heals, God heals, or God please heal. He is one of the 3 angels that appeared to Abraham in the Book of Genesis. The angel is also mentioned in the Gospel of John as stirring the waters at the healing pool of Bethesda. And Raphael is a venerated angel within the Roman Catholic, Eastern Orthodox, Anglican, and Lutheran traditions. In Islam, he is known as Israfil, who traditionally attributed to the trumpet, which is poised at his lips, and when God so commands, he shall be ready to announce the day of resurrection. No defending then? In the Book of Enoch, he is the one of the 5 angels who keep watch over both the celestial and terrestrial worlds, but no guarding the Garden of Eden specifically. That is guarded by the cherubim, angelic creatures. Okay, so let's just say that the letter was a mistake my mother made and she just assumed he guarded the Garden of Eden. He is a guardian of the celestial and terrestrial worlds anyway. For that reason, he is often depicted with a staff or a sword. And for some reason, he is holding a fish in his left hand in a few pictures. But she clearly believed there were 4 archangels and one of them was Daniel. So could it be that it actually was like that at one time, and this is an ME for my mother, which is just another clue that the Mandela is affecting this world a lot longer than some people believe. So what do you think? Your thoughts and opinions are much appreciated, so drop a line in the box below. Just be respectful in the comments, as there are real people with real feelings on the other side. There is a lot more to tell about this topic than I covered in this small vid, and if you wish to do your own research, the links in the description of my sources might be a good start. If I have forgot something or you have something to add, do not hesitate to do so. If you enjoyed this vid, you can like and share and subscribe to my channel, and you may want to click the little bell to receive notifications. I have my You Decide channel you might want to check out. And from my corner in this weird world to yours, I hope to see you next time. Bye!